สวัสดีค่ะ This time we will look at the acid-base properties of salts. What are salts? Basically, they are ionic compounds which consist of cation and anion. Salt are the products of acid-base neutralization reaction, which can be shown as this one. Acid react with base, give salt plus water. So from acid and base lesson, we have two types of acid or base, one strong, one weak. So the combination of acid and base to make salt can be in four categories like this. We can combine strong acid to strong base, strong acid to weak base, weak acid to strong base, or weak acid and weak base. All of this will produce salt. So let's see actual acid and base example. Strong acid, strong base make salt and water. Strong acid here hydrochloric, strong base here sodium hydroxide. It's gonna give salt, sodium chloride and water. The combination is like this. Hydrogen and hydroxide make water. Sodium ion and chloride ion make sodium chloride. Next example, strong acid and weak base. This time weak base. Example is ammonium hydroxide. Ammonium ion will combine with chloride ion, give salt ammonium chloride. Example of weak acid and strong base. Weak acid, hydrocyanic acid, HCN. The sodium ion combine to cyanide ion, make sodium cyanide. Last one, weak acid react to weak base. Hydrocyanic acid react with ammonium hydroxide, give the salt ammonium cyanide and water. From this example, you see that all the salt has cation and anion. Cation come from base. Anion come from acid. So we can see that salt has cation from base, anion from acid. This particular salt comes from strong base and strong acid. So we can call this salt as a salt of strong base and strong acid. Same thing. Sodium chloride is a salt of strong base and strong acid. Ammonium chloride is a salt of weak base and strong acid. Sodium cyanide is a salt of strong base and weak acid. Of course, ammonium cyanide would be salt of weak base and weak acid. I put a highlight here, strong and strong. Okay. This one strong acid, this one strong base. So the pH of the solution of these salts would be different. So let's see the pH of salt solutions. Salts are strong electrolytes that completely ionized in water. This means all the salt that consists of cation and anion would separate into ions in water completely, 100%. The pH of the solution would depend on the hydrolysis of those ions. This is called the salt hydrolysis, which means that the ion will react with water. If the salt hydrolysis occurs, it usually affects the pH of a solution. The reason is that when salt hydrolysis occurs, the concentration of hydronium ion or hydroxide ion in water would change, and that would affect the pH value. Here is the ionization of salt. This is the salt of strong base and strong acid. Salt will separate into cation and anion in water. So we're going to look at the hydrolysis of this ion. In this particular example, sodium ion and chloride ion cannot react with water. There will be no reaction. How do we know this? Sodium ion will not take proton from water because this is positive, right? It will not take proton from water. Why? Chloride ion may take proton from water, but when it did that, it's gonna make HCl, right? HCl. Everyone must know by now that HCl is a strong acid, which will separate into ion as well in water, right? So chloride ion will not take proton from water. So we're gonna say that both ion will not react with water, so no reaction. Since there is no reaction or no hydrolysis of both ion, there would be no changes of hydronium ion concentration or hydroxide ion concentration in water. Therefore, the pH of this salt dissolved in water would be equal to 7. And if you look at this salt, this is the type of salt that comes from strong base and strong acid. Salt of strong base and strong acid will give pH of the solution equal to 7. This time, see ammonium chloride salt. This is the salt of weak base and strong acid. Ammonium chloride will separate into ammonium ion and chloride ion. We saw from last slide that chloride ion will not react with water, so be no reaction. How about ammonium ion? Ammonium ion is a conjugate acid of weak base ammonia, so it can react to water. It will give proton to water because it is an acid. Give proton to water, make ammonia, and of course, hydronium ion. So from this reaction, we see that hydronium ion is a product. So the hydronium ion concentration would increase. And when hydronium ion concentration increase, the pH of the solution would be an acid, which means less than 7. And if you look at the combination here, I highlighted, this is the salt of weak base and strong acid. The solution would be acidic solution. So it in align with this strong acid, give solution as acidic solution. Next example, sodium cyanide. This is the salt of strong base and weak acid. Can you guess? The solution would be basic, นะคะ because this is highlighted here, strong base. If we consider what happening, same thing นะคะ sodium cyanide separate into sodium ion and cyanide ion. Sodium ion doesn't react with water. Cyanide ion, this is the conjugate base of the weak acid, hydrocyanic acid. So it react to water, it a weak base. So it receive proton from water. That means hydroxide ion is produced. So hydroxide ion concentration is increased. pH of the solution would be more than 7. This would make basic solution. Same thing นะคะ It's aligned to the strong base part of the salt. Salt of strong base and weak acid would give the solution as basic solution. The last type of salt. Salt of weak base and weak acid. Salt of weak base and weak acid. When we see strong base and strong acid, the solution is neutral, right? How about weak base and weak acid? Would the solution be neutral again? Let's see. Ammonium cyanide separate into ammonium ion and cyanide ion. From the previous slides, both ions can react to water, right? One reaction produces hydronium ion, another reaction produces hydroxide ion. So, both hydronium ion and hydroxide ion are increased. How about the pH? It's question mark here. You cannot say that both are increased, so they're gonna cancel out. No, we have to consider the equilibrium here, both of them. If hydronium ion is produced more than hydroxide ion, the solution would be acidic. In the contrary, if hydroxide ion is produced more than hydronium ion, the solution would be basic. How do we gonna find out about this? So if we look at the equilibrium, we can get Ka, Kb to consider, right? We can get Ka and Kb of ammonium ion or cyanide ion. If Ka of ammonium ion is higher than Kb of cyanide ion, the hydronium ion here would be more than hydroxide. Let's find out. So here are the value of Ka of ammonium ion and Kb of cyanide ion. Ka of ammonium ion is 5.6 times 10 to the minus 10, where Kb of cyanide ion is 1.6 times 10 to the minus 5. Compare these two values. We see that Kb is more than Ka, right? From this value, this equilibrium will produce more hydroxide ion than this equilibrium produces hydronium ion. Take the value and compare, นะคะ again. Kb is higher than Ka. Hydroxide will be produced more than hydronium ion. So the concentration of hydroxide ion would be dominant, and that will make the solution to have pH higher than 7. So in summary of this video, we talk about the solution of salts, which may be acidic, basic, or neutral, depends on the combination of the cation and anion. Because of the hydrolysis of those ions, that will affect the concentration of hydronium ion and hydroxide ion in water, which result in the different value of pH. And four different type of salts give different value of pH like this. Salt that make from strong base and strong acid, strong and strong, balance it out. No hydrolysis of ion, the pH will be equal to 7. Salt made from strong base and weak acid will have a basic properties, pH higher than 7. Salt from weak base and strong acid will have an acidic property, pH less than 7, where salt from weak base and weak acid, we cannot predict pH directly, but we have to consider the value of Ka and Kb of the ions. So that's it for this one, นะคะ. I see you again next time. สวัสดีค่ะ.